Bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillahi wa ba'd. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we continue to talk about the a'mal salihah, the righteous deeds, where inshallah we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He accepts them and that we maximize our rewards as the companions themselves did when they would wear themselves out in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. They would keep awake at night and through the day you would see them in acts of ibadah, constantly trying to do as many a'mal salihah as possible. Now, what's beautiful is we want to talk about salah in this episode, about prayer and increasing our prayer, inshallah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. What's beautiful is it brings us full circle round to what we started this discussion about, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Fajr, He makes oaths. He said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر. Sadaqallah al-Azim, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He swore by the dawn, which of course Fajr itself is one of the names of the prayers, a very important, and we said earlier as well, actually the most significant part of the day, the Fajr time. And He swore by, of course, the 10 nights, which we said were the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, was Shafi'i wal Watar, and by the even, which is, we said, is the Eid al-Adha, the 10th of Dhul Hijjah, and the odd, which is the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, the day of Arafah, wal Layli Idha Yasir, and by the night when it passes. And we said at that time, and we'll state it again here, my dear brothers and sisters, that you've got the Fajr time being emphasized, which is linked to the first 10 days of the Hijjah. So what the scholars make mention of is that we must ensure when we're doing these acts of A'mal Salihah, the righteous deeds in these first 10 days of the Hijjah, we must absolutely not neglect our Fard. This is the first thing, first and foremost. There's absolutely no way we should be doing these extra fasting and then neglecting our Fard Salah. Makes no sense. So yes, wake up, have your Suhoor, it's a time of Barakah, pray Tahajjud and pray Fajr. What mustn't be happening is we have the fast and we missed our Fajr Salah. Not at all. It's very important, my dear ministers, that we use this time, if our prayers are somewhat awry, that we use this time to fix our Salah, make sure the 5 daily prayers are being prayed fi waqtiha, in its allotted time. Let us not forget, my dear brothers and sisters, that in the Sunan of Abi Dawud, rahmatullahi, he mentions the hadith of Abu Huraira, radiallahu anhu. He said, I heard the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, the first deed for which a servant of Allah will be reckoned on the Day of Judgment will be his salah. Look at this. The first thing, my dear brothers and sisters, we will be asked about on the Day of Judgment will be our salah. And don't forget, in some narrations we have, that from the last words that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said before his soul was taken, as-salah, 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 prayer, 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 prayer. Don't forget the word salah in Arabic is word from the Arabic word sila, which means a connection, because it's a connection between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, and us, his servants. It's our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith continues, if the salah is good, he has succeeded and prospered. Allahu Akbar, meaning, if a person prays 5 times a day, is praying their Fard Salah, it's good. Alhamdulillah, Day of Judgment is good. Otherwise, and this is where many of us really need to be careful, otherwise he will be in loss and failure. If there is any deficiency in his Fard Salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord Most High, will say, see if my servant has any other optional Salah which he completed, which has been omitted from his compulsory prayers. Then the rest of his deeds will be dealt with in a similar manner. What do we learn from this hadith, my dear brothers and sisters? We learn that the very first thing we'll be asked about on the Day of Judgment will be our salah. The Prophet ﷺ is advising his ummah right to his dying breath, alayhi salatu wasalam, telling us to pray, my dear brothers and sisters. It's the sila, it's the connection between us and our Lord. And we're being told that this is the first thing we'll be accounted for on the Day of Judgment. And if there's a deficiency in the Fard Salah, Allah will be looking at the Sunan and Nawafil Salah to make up for the loss in the Fard Salah. And this is something, first and foremost, we want to say, make sure the Fard Salah is correct. And now let's give some advice about the Sunan prayers that we should be looking to do, especially engaging in these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, that they become a habit within us and that we continue this way before and way after the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, as is narrated by Habiba radiallahu anha, she said, قَالَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ صَلَّ فِي يَوْمٍ وَلَيْلَةٍ ثَنَتَيْ عَشَرَ رَقْعَ بُنِيَ لَهُ بَيْتٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Allahu Akbar. that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, whoever prays in a day and a night 12 units of prayer, 12 raka'ah, buniya lahu baytun fil jannah, he will have a house built for him in Jannah. Allahu Akbar. And before you start to say, oh, this must be the 5 daily prayers, wait, it's not about the fara'id, it's about the sunan. Arba'an qabla dhuhr, 4 sunnah raka'ah before dhuhr, wa raka'atayn ba'daha, and 2 after dhuhr. So 4 sunnahs before dhuhr, pray the 4 fard of dhuhr, and then 2 sunnah after dhuhr. Now we have 6. Wa raka'atayn ba'd al-maghrib, and 2 sunnah prayers after maghrib. So now we have 8. Wa raka'atayn ba'd al-isha, and 2 after salat al-isha. Again, the sunnah prayers after isha. Wa raka'atayn qabla salat al-fajr, and the 2 sunnahs before the Fajr Salah, which we heard in a previous hadith, the Prophet never gave up ever in his life. So now what we're hearing, my dear brothers and sisters, we want to be tactical here. We just learned from the other hadith that if we have a failing in our Fard Salah, and we need to do qada of those, but if we have a failing there, Allah will look to our Sunan prayers. What we learned from this beautiful hadith in the Sunan of Imam Tirmidhi, the Jami' of Imam Tirmidhi, Rahmat Alayhi, is that if we pray 12 Sunnah prayers, so we were speaking about here, these are the which will give you a house built in Jannah, 4 before Dhuhr, 2 after Dhuhr, 2 after Maghrib, 2 after Isha, and 2 before Fajr, you will have a house built for you in Paradise. And may Allah give us tawfiq for that. And then, my dear brothers and sisters, as the ayah said, وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسَرْ, and by the night as it departs. The ulama in the tafsir, they interpret that as being the time of tahajjud, the athulath al-akhir min al-layl, it's the last third of the night, a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend in a manner which is befitting to him, to the lowest sky, and he will say, who is awake now? Tahajjud, remember, my dear brothers, it actually means you've gone to sleep and now you've woken up tahajjudun, which means to avoid sleep. You are avoiding sleep for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praying 2 raka'ah, 2s and then 4s and more if Allah has given you tawfiq. Especially if we're going to fast these days, let's be tactical. We have our suhoor, but we're praying tahajjud before the adhan of Salat al-Fajr goes. Let's bring this practice as we did in Ramadan. Let's bring this into the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. We'll carry great reward, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. So now, this, what Allah swears by the time of tahajjud. This is the point. And now let's connect this with the hadith in Sahih Muslim, in which Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, أَفْضُلُ السِّيَامُ بَعْدُ الرَّمَضَانِ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ الْمُحَرَّمُ. He said, the fasting which has the most merit with Allah after Ramadan is the sacred month of Allah, Muharram. It's the first of the Islamic year. It's one of the 4 sacred months. And of course, it's a beautiful way to start the next Islamic year, that we start it in a state of shukr, in fasting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then he goes on to say, وَأَفْضُلُ الصَّلَاةَ بَعْضُ الْفَرِيدَةِ, but the best meritorious salah, prayer after the fard prayers, the 5 fard prayers, is Salat al-Layl, is praying at night, my dear brothers and sisters. And we know also with that carries the du'as, which are mustajab in the last third of the night, in the time of the Hajj, inshallah, they carry with them great weight with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And of course, as we said this hadith before, and we'll bring it back here again, because we don't tire of mentioning this hadith, that when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam spoke about the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, he said, remember, he said, there are no days in this dunya, in this entire world, which in which worship, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worshipped, which is more beloved to Allah, glorious be He, than the first day, 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And remember, he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, that fasting in one of these days is equivalent to fasting 1 year. That just gives you an idea of the degree of blessing, of the multitude of blessings that are available in the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And then, my dear brothers and sisters, and we want to end this episode with this, and how beautiful it is, wa laylatin fiha bi laylatil qadr. Allahu Akbar. And if we do qiyam, if we stand in the first 10 nights of Dhul Hijjah, that this will be equal to as if we were standing on the night of power, Allahu Akbar, which is khayrun min alfi shahr, is better than 1,000 months. We pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the tawfiq to increase our fard, to make sure our fard salah are correct and being prayed at the right time, and that, as we said, to increase by adding to them our sunan prayers, the 12 raka'ah of sunan prayers with our 5 fard prayers, but of course adding the nawafil as well, the extra prayers we can do, which of course the most superior of them, as we saw in the hadith, is the salat al-layl, the prayer by night. This is the prayer of tahajjud, the qiyam al-layl, that we can do as well, inshallah. And we pray that Allah accepts our du'as at that time. It's the time of istijaba, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds to the du'as. And of course, we should use this period, my dear brothers and sisters, to have tarkul ma'asi. We should be looking to rid ourselves and avoid sins and to do tawbah to Allah. And nadmu huwa tawbah. The Prophet ﷺ said, regret is true tawbah, that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely in these 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, increasing our salah, increasing our du'as, avoiding our sins and doing tawbah to Allah. Let us not forget when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke, and we spoke about this a while ago, spoke about the four sacred months. He says, وَلَا تَذْلِمُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ فِيهِنَّ. Do not wrong yourselves in these sacred months. Don't forget, my dear brothers and sisters, that no doubt the good deeds are increased, the reward of them is multitude increased in the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah, but also be warned, and it's a warning to myself first and foremostly, that we have to avoid sins, because sinning in the four sacred months also carries far more punishment. May Allah give us tawfiq, inshallah, to take the good of this advice. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The best 10 days. Automate your zakat and sadaqah donations and maximize your rewards during the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Visit muslimhands.org.uk/best10days.